Hey guys, it's Generic Joe. Welcome back to Let's Play Project M Subspace Emissary Edition. Last time we started the adventure in the Skyworld in the Sea of Clouds and the stadium, but you can't see it because it's covered by subspace on the map. Ooh. So this time around we're gonna go to the jungle, and I also didn't check to see if my name was applied. that's great. Then we got some thievery going on. Punching. And the Kremlings are nowhere in sight, I guess. So Donkey Kong has to fight Mario in these. And all those bananas should totally be falling off, by the way. Was that manual fire? How did that work? If only beat up pop guns were that powerful in the actual game. Maybe they are, I'm not sure. It feels like they moved nowhere and now they're going like turbo speed and crap. Alright. So I'm gonna be playing as Dong because I'm better with him than I am with Diddy. Not by much, but better. So, one thing I actually tried to do off screen is Of course I get the moon mushroom. This is being recorded a day after the first episode, so I learned a couple things. Like, for example, Subspace Emissary was not in original versions of Project M, but they added it later in a separate version. I don't know if it was 3.6 or anything, but it was added. It was not there from the start, so it, like, didn't work at first, but it was still an option on the menu, because this is just a model brawl. It kept all the options there and stuff. You know, it's kind of dumb and complicated. Or needlessly complicated, as it's supposed to be. And another thing I tried to do was, off-screen, I tried to install Project M EX. Which is pretty much a mod of a mod. It's an improved version of Project M made by fans other than the original development team. Pretty much added some extra content and stuff. Can I not break this? Oh, of course, right, cannon. I don't know why I thought I could just break that. Shows you how long it's been since I've played this. Dude, I haven't played Brawl in a long time. Subspace Emissary, too. Oh god! I actually missed! I was just assuming, you know, like, it would just go. I guess that's the aiming system for you. I figured out this gives you, like, turbo stuff. Or something, I don't know. I saw what it did, but I forget what it did. That lightning bolt power up there. It's exclusive to Project M. Anyways, Project MEX, I tried to get it to work. I'm not playing that here because I could not get it to work. That really sucks. I'm trying to get stickers. You can only get them when you're on the ground, which sucks. Ooh, launcher. Run shell. Is that Skarmory? Yeah, I think it is. Get rid of the shell. Oh, the launcher's gone. What happened? But yeah, you can grab enemies with the whatever your grab button is. But you just automatically throw them. So you can't choose the direction you want to throw. Well, actually, maybe you can choose the direction, but you can't hold them easy. So I couldn't, like, take a Koopa, carry him on my back, and then go off at the edge of something just to suicide a Koopa. Or suicide with a Koopa. Double kill, in a sense. And, oh no! I didn't mean to hit myself with that. So I found out yesterday what happens when you try- Oh god! Really? I found out what yesterday what happens when you try to, sticker, thank you. When you try to beat Classic Mode with Mewtwo or Roy in this, you'll be able to go through it just fine. Mewtwo and Roy won't actually show up in Classic Mode because it's just Brawl's Classic Mode. You'll just play through it with Mewtwo or Roy. It'll just be, you know, like normally is. Stages will be different because of the placement of certain stages, replacing others, and, oh god, no! No! Being moved in place of others. Like, for example, I don't think you've had the Pokemon on just Pokemon Stadium 2, you can go to Saffron City as well. You know, ooh, CD. But yeah, I did play this quite a bit and found something out about the game's progress. Oh yes, I actually made it. I found out that Brawl and Project M's memory are tied to one another. So Project M and Brawl's memory are the same thing. So if you beat a few events in Brawl and then go to Project M, it'll say you beat those events in Project M even though you didn't. Because of the fact that the memory is tied. So if you beat Classic Mode with like 5 characters, it'll say you beat Classic Mode with 5 characters when you go back to Brawl, and vice versa. And when you beat Classic Mode with Roy or Mewtwo, towards the end when they give you your trophy, they give you a Mario trophy. But then they actually have their own congratulations screen, so that's pretty cool. Something else to mention, speaking of a Mario trophy, if you use the Snake Codex on Mewtwo or Roy, it just gives you the Mario conversation. So pretty much, the game thinks it's just Mario, when really it is not at all Mario. Neither of them are. It does that with both. With the Snake Codec, at least, it does that with both. But anyways, we found our Banana Horde. Shortest DKC game ever, but Bowser! What? Karate Kong. Or sorry, Karate Dong. And then he does nothing to protect himself. I feel like with how high Diddy flew into how high he flew up and like how fast he was going, he should like be dead. Mother 3 love theme. Don't remember what that sounds like. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and save. I don't even know why I have these extra files here, but whatever. Let's overwrite the first one. So now we got Diddy Kong on our team. So now we'll go to the plane. And we get to play as a... Okay, so we get to play as Mario or Pit. I'm gonna go with... You cannot change anything about these guys, alright. I can't, like, change skins or anything. So we're gonna go with Mario. I don't remember this stage showing up this early. Or maybe I'm thinking something else. Yeah, I might be thinking of the Great Plane, actually. So, something that I can't guarantee that this is gonna happen, so don't get your hopes up over this, but, I may, in the future, get someone else to join me for one or two episodes of this project. Like Evan, for example. My friend Evan. Yes! I might, find a way to trick him into thinking I'm playing Brawl. And just going in to load up some custom stages, and then just... You know... Whatever. Not whatever. Trick him into thinking I'm loading up custom stages, and then turns out you're playing Project M, and I don't even think he knows what Project M is, so it's gonna be an even bigger surprise. And then he'll go over to his grandma's and find that copy of Brawl that he has over there and try to get the game for himself. But you know, I don't blame him. It's really cool. And especially considering you don't have to hack your Wii in order to get it. For for 3.6 at least, which is what I'm playing. I know the newest update for Project MVX is hackless, but oh crap! No! Shit! Wait, I'm still alive? Oh, no, I'm not. Oh yeah, this is Brawl, so Pit has the, he has the... Oh no, he doesn't. Right, this isn't Brawl. I found that out yesterday. That move. Oh, it's a Krumling. Speaking of Krumlings, I should probably play a DKC game. At all. I've never played any of them except for Donkey Kong Country Returns. That's it. That's the only one I've played. I would really like to play the others. At the very least, the first one. Also, I think there's something up here. I can't wall jump, so I can't get up there. I feel like there was something up there, but I can't remember. Maybe it's just the place for the enemies to spawn. I remember as a kid, I had the toughest time trying to get up there. So... I wonder if they're actually going to incorporate Mewtwo and Roy into Subspace. I doubt it, but that would be pretty cool to see. Are his taunts the same? I think they are. I'm pretty sure that's the same actor or actress. Yes, I meant to say actress. It's voiced by a chick in this game. But in Smash 4, he was voiced by a guy, so trade off. Yeah, trade off. That's entirely what that means. Get this Franklin badge or not, I just... Oh, well, we're at the end anyway, so it's not like... Oh, wait! It does matter! I am invincible! Because I'm invincible, that thing will blow up and I won't be affected by it. Yes, I got the trophy for that! I've never gotten the trophy for that before. Ever. Like, seriously. All my time playing this game, never got that before. This last guy, and then Llama their lives, and there's no door. It's just a beam of light. The ancient minister has another bomb. And it is addicted to Mario. I forgot that he can fly. Generic announcer voice. Yay, that level meant nothing. It's like the first level, it's like the first mission in Sonic 06. It means absolutely nothing in terms of plot. Alright, the lake. Ooh, the lake. I remember this one. Oh, so I guess real quick I'm gonna explain those icons on the map. A crown over the stage means you've gotten all the extras in the stage. A flag means you have not gotten them. A flag just means you've beaten the stage, but a crown means you've beaten the stage and gotten the items. The exclamation mark within the speech bubble is the next stage, the new stage. And if you go in and then leave the stage, which you can do, and then go back, it'll just be a circle with no special marks. Yeah, Fox should totally be dead, by the way. But whatever. Should've waited a second for that to show up. Of course I'm going to Fox. Here I come! I like how they got the same actor for play Fox from Assault, but he sounds so much better here. Oh crap! Why did I not move there? I don't know. And it's dead. I did not see what that trophy was. Yeah. Very strange sounding clip. No, the plot's this way. Fox again. Remember this scene, it's gonna come up again later. In almost the exact same way. So, right now we're playing A Link to the Past. With Star Fox, I guess. That's basically what this is. But with doors, and it takes a takes just as long to load these sections as it does in Brawl, so that's not good. Alright, it's a new enemy type. And they hurt quite a bit, but after they hurt you, they're useless. So you can just destroy them if you want. Let's not defend ourselves! Okay, so Fox can wall jump, apparently. I like that animation for the shooting with the gun. Shooting with the gun, yeah. I don't get why that room just feels the need to be super dark. Like, why is the room super dark? You just have to find a bomb, and they show you where it is before it goes dark. I don't understand why they felt the need to do that. Yeah, I think there's some goodies over here. Ooh, yeah, there is. Combos. Ah, no. Oh, hon, really? In the game. It was over to the right. Okay, just enemies. Over here. Alright, so it looks like this is gonna be the last stage of the episode. So once I finish this... go. Ow! No! No, why'd you have to make noise and ruin me? Oh yeah, this is a thing. So if you go up here, it's a room of fire. And this reminds me of an old time during my youngin' years. Basically, my mom had a friend over, and that friend of hers had her son come over as well. And so, the son saw that I had a Wii and a copy of Smash Bros. Brawl, and it's like, hey, can we play that? I'm like, sure. So we went to Subspace, we got to this stage, and played it, and then we got to the fire room, and there was one point where we kept going to the fire room, where it was just like the guy who was player one wouldn't leave, and that was Diddy Kong at the time. So then when, so then he's like, alright, you know what, I have an idea, since you're not gonna go out, we're just gonna cheat it. So we hit reconnect, for the controllers, like, here, he went to reconnect, and switched it so that he would be player one, so we could leave the room, but when it reconnected, I was still player one, and then he just said, you're still Diddy! You're still Diddy! He had an accent, by the way. I guess I should have mentioned that already. I don't know why, but that was just hilarious. When I was younger. Alright, so what now? Alright, looks like this episode's gonna be longer than 20 minutes. That sucks. All this taunting the same, I guess. Whoa. What's transparency on that? That was weird. This is some epic secrets. Some epic secrets, yeah. Hey, another stock. I just realized I haven't died at all. Watch me die with, like, as soon as I leave the room. My mobility. Oh no! No! Hey, it's the grandma from Wind Waker. Wow. Good enemy. Yeah, this is gonna be longer than, like... This is gonna be, like, 25 minutes long. I think this is the last section, though, so... I kinda wish they would've had a cutscene for that. Oh well, what can you do? Like, either version of the game, like Project M overall, would have a cutscene for that. But whatever. Not that big of a deal. Get some Metamatoes. Oh yeah, I remember what's coming up! This is the last section. Right here. You get to fight Evil Bowser. Wait. Evil Bowser? But wait. It's not. But he's already evil. Whatever. Anyways. So as you can see down in the corner next to his portrait, the icon that he has is not the standard mushroom icon like the rest of the Mario characters. That is because Bowser is actually classified as a different character. He has his own Bowser logo, which looks pretty cool. Oh no. And, another thing they did, another reason they changed it, is because, they added a new victory theme for him. So, yeah, before Smash 4 added a new victory theme for him, my life's reset! Really? My life's just reset. Great. So, those two stocks that I got meant nothing. Of course, that's when the first death happens. Anyways... They changed his victory theme, so yeah, Project M changed Bowser's victory theme for Nintendo. It's not the same thing, of course, but... Like, Smash 4 and Project M victory themes for Bowser are not the same thing, but... These guys did it first. And they also added Skyworld as a... Or, not Skyworld. I keep calling it that. Skyloft from Skyward Sword as a stage as well. He's infected! Yeah, that's what it was. It was infected Bowser. Dark gun! It shoots arrows. Why does it blow up? Why does it blow up? It's just supposed to turn people into trophies. Why does it explode? Alright, whatever. Stage clear. Thanks, Grandma. Salvatore. Oh yeah, that guy. I remember him now. Ooh, the Ruined Zoo. This is gonna be interesting. So, I guess I'm gonna have 3 saves per video. I mean, that's happened twice now. Anyways, that's all for this episode. I'm Super Ultra Hyper Fighter Fighting Force. I said fight twice in that sentence. See you guys next time for whatever here on my channel. Goodbye.